Hey guys, happy Monday after Thanksgiving. It's not December yet, but it sure feels like it. We're like already in the holidays, in my opinion. My entire neighborhood has all of their Christmas lights up already, including us, because the pressure was on to get it done. So we are all set for the holidays. We still have to get our tree, but it is happening a lot quicker than I anticipated. It feels like the end of the year is already here. But anyway, I'm out here enjoying the weather today. Cleo is as well. She's sleeping, I promise, sunbathing over there. And you can't see Zoe, but she's hanging out with her ball in the shade, as she likes to do. But thank you guys so much for coming back and watching this video. But if it's your first time, make sure you subscribe. I post new updates of what's going on in the Phoenix real estate market every Monday. And that's what I'm doing today. So if that's something that interests you, make sure you subscribe. I would really appreciate it. I'm Caitlin McKegg. I'm a real estate broker here in the Phoenix area. And as I said, I give updates every Monday. I also post other videos about living in Phoenix and Phoenix real estate here. So let's jump into it. What is going on now as we enter December of 2021? What's going on as we are getting into the holiday season and that kind of thing? So first, I'm gonna talk about typically our seasonal trends right now is that our supply starts to decrease and our demand usually does as well. People get distracted with the holidays and not everyone is interested in listing their house or going out and buying a house unless they have to. So demand and supply usually start to kind of taper off at this time of year. What's actually going on? Our supply is tapering off. So that's seasonal, but our demand is increasing. Once again, you never know what to expect after 2020. Things have not been normal or seasonal pretty much at all. So here we are, our demand is increasing as we're going into December, but the supply is decreasing. So what does that mean? Usually when demand is up and supply is down, that typically means that prices go up because there is more interest for a fewer amount of homes on the market. So we'll see if that's the case. I don't know if 1 month is gonna make that much of an impact, but a tip for you if you are thinking about listing your home, might be a good time to do it because our demand is up and everyone else who usually lists their home is going that seasonal trend and not listing right now. So you might be one of the few on the market. If you are thinking about buying a home, keep in mind right now there aren't a whole lot of homes on the market, but you may be able to find one before demand really increases in January, which is what we typically see. Again, though, I don't know if that's gonna be the trend in January because it's so hard to know what's going on these days as far as predicting trends and that kind of thing. So that's where we're at with supply and demand right now, and wanted to mention that depending on if you are thinking about buying or selling a home. Also wanted to talk about our appreciation right now. Appreciation is weaker than it has been in the past, but it's still not weak. Our appreciation has come down to 28% from the peak at 39%, and that's annual appreciation. So I've mentioned this before, but to put this in context, appreciation in a balanced market is usually about the rate of inflation, which is typically somewhere between 3 to 5%. It's different now, inflation has been higher, but typically in a balanced market, that's where your appreciation rates go. Now in a seller's market, appreciation rates are much higher. So again, we've come down to 28%, but when 3 to 5% is the normal in a balanced market, this 28% is actually quite good. And to think about 39%, just crazy. So appreciation rates are weaker, but not weak. Let's see, what else do I have for you guys today? The median sales price in the Phoenix area, the greater Phoenix area, is $425,000. That is up 27% from last November. So I know that prices have continued to go up. I know that I talk about that a lot and we all know that, but when you really look at the percentage increase when you're comparing median sales price, 27% is a big number. So if you bought last November, congrats to you. You have had a ton of appreciation, and home prices are so much higher now than they were last year. So keep that in mind if you are on the fence about buying. Right now, we anticipate that prices will continue to increase at least for the next 3 to 6 months. And that is based off of the Cromford Report. So let me talk about that for a second. I follow the Cromford Report. I talk about this every week. The Cromford Report is a subscription for realtors, and they analyze all the data in the MLS to help us understand what's going on in the market. One of the things that they look at is supply and demand factors, and they have an index that helps us understand which way prices are going based on supply and demand in the market. And so their indicator says that if the number is over 110, we are in a seller's market, and if it's below 90, we're in a buyer's market. Anything in between that 90 to 110 is a balanced market. And holy cow, we are at 358 right now, which has been creeping up, but really in the last 30 days, it has turned into a very strong seller's market. We've moved in that direction undoubtedly. And for a while we were kind of hanging out for a bit and still very much in a seller's market, but things had weakened. If you haven't been watching these videos, back in March, I was talking about 514 as the market index number. So now at 358, yes, we've weakened, but we were down in the 340s. And so in the last 30 days, there is a clear change in direction towards a seller's market, a stronger seller's market. So that is an important thing I wanted to talk about. So 358 on the CMI, and then also wanted to share the supply and the demand numbers. So supply is sitting at 34, which means that we are about 66% below normal. If 100 is normal, 34 is 66% below. And then demand, on the flip side, that is 123, so that is 23% above normal. So you can see where we're at with supply and demand being in two very different places. So brings me back to the point I was going to make. The reason that they are saying prices will continue to increase over the next 3 to 6 months is because the market index tells us that when any number of this index is over 110, we are going to see price increases. Whether they are small or large, it depends on how intense the seller's market is. Back when we were at 514, that is the year where we saw this 37-39% appreciation, right? So now we are at a lower number, our appreciation rates are less, but we are not seeing prices decline. And so when our supply is that much lower than our demand, and our demand continues to increase, really just basic economics, prices are gonna continue to increase. So can't say how long that's going to be, but based on the index and based on everything that the Cromford Report studies, it is very, very likely that prices will continue to increase over the next 3 to 6 months. And I will continue to update you guys as I get more info from them on a weekly or bi-weekly basis. So that's all I've got. If you have questions, make sure to comment below or send me an email. You can reach out to me anytime. I've got my contact information in the description, and also have a link in there if you want to set up a time to chat with me directly. You can do it through there as well. Cleo's trying to say hi. I think she's ready to go inside, so I'm going to wrap this up. And thank you so much for watching. I hope you guys have a great week.